Work it, make it, do it. Makes us all the better, faster, stronger. Work it, that
don't kill me. Can only make me stronger. I need you to hurry up now. Cause I can't wait much longer. I know I got to be right now. Cause I can't get much stronger. Man, I've been waiting all night now. That's how long I've been on ya.
Application, and we will make sure that we send that in for you. The second way that you all can vote by mail, is voting early. So early voting starts on August 22nd. So if you all would like to vote early, you all can go out and vote early from August 22nd, starting in August 22nd. And then the third way that you all can vote, of course, is on election day. So September 1st, if you're comfortable, making sure that you wear your mask and you stay socially distant. If you all feel comfortable, go out and vote on September 1st. So those are the three ways that you all can vote. Really quickly, if you have not signed in to today's event, we would like everyone to text the word HERE to 63033. Again, if you...
How's everyone doing today? I can't hear you. How's everyone doing today? Are you ready to send Joe Kennedy to Senate?
Yeah.
I can't hear you. Are you ready to send Joe Kennedy to the Senate?
Yeah.
Okay. My name is Tito Jackson. Am I allowed? My name is Tito Jackson. I'm the former District 7 Boston City Councilor. But today, I am here endorsing the next Senator for the state of Massachusetts, my man, Joe Kennedy. And I actually, there's a whole bunch of people who can talk policy. I'm gonna let those policy people do their thing. Policy people. One, I wanna give a shout out to two of our most esteemed business owners, folks in our community who've been here, not only through this difficult time, but through many other difficult times. First of all, and if y'all are eating, ladies and gentlemen, y'all need to clap way louder than that. But, ladies and gentlemen, shout out to my man, Tony Brewer. The mouth from the south, a.k.a. Elm Hill, but it's all good, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, I come here, this one's personal to me. In 2015, I was a city councilor. I was chair of education. In the Boston Public Schools, most of our kids actually get free lunch. Most of them are poor. 45% of our students are Latino. 35% of our students are black, and every single one of them, 100% of them, is our future, right? And I took that job very, very serious. And I had an opportunity, I got a call. Somebody said somebody from the Kennedys was on the line. I was like, okay, do they have the wrong number? One of the Kennedys is calling the brother? And I got a call that Joe Kennedy, Congressman Joe Kennedy, wanted to come to Roxbury. And he wanted to understand what's going on with urban public education, what's happening in special education, what's happening with English language learners, and what our young people as well as our teachers need. And without, we got cameras here today. There was no cameras there that day, ladies and gentlemen. When Joe Kennedy went into classrooms in Roxbury, when we went into special ed classrooms and talked to the teachers, when we went into some buildings that needed to be fixed up. On one side of the building it's hot, and then on the other side of the building it's cold. And shout out to Nivea because she's a teacher, so we got to give her a shout. Let's give a shout out to teachers, ladies and gentlemen. And I believe that Joe comes from a long line and a lineage of a family that has served our community, has fought and died to make it better, and has stepped forward on issues of civil rights, human rights, and will go to Washington and fight the fight that we need to have fought down there and win and make sure that people of color, that women, folks from the LGBT community, and those folks who've been left behind, that they get what they need, that they want and deserve. And that's why today I'm endorsing my brother, Joe Kennedy, for Senate. And I just leave you with, there's a whole lot of hateration that's out there. Yep. Hateration and holleration.
Right.
When it comes down to it, we're not actually going against anybody. This is about what Joe is for. Where Joe has stood. And in fact, it's also about someone who Joe and I didn't always agree on some issues. Right? But we sat down, and in fact, we at Enrique's wedding, to his wife's chagrin, we had a conversation. And so we live in a day and age, ladies and gentlemen, where folks can't speak to each other. People, when they disagree with one another, they shut down, they cancel one another, and they don't actually stand up and stay with the conversation. I am supporting Joe Kennedy because of the candidate who he is, but more so because of the person he is. He continues to get better every day. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I want to go ahead and pass the mic on to my brother from another mother. He's the sheriff, not a cop, but he's the sheriff. And he's someone who we did some things together that we never... What's up, Rondo? Rondo. But... Scalabrini is in the house. Assist for Scalabrini. Exactly. So, we did some things together, and I want to give a huge shout-out to the sheriff of this county, the only black sheriff in the state of Massachusetts, ladies and gentlemen. Sheriff Steve Tompkins, and the first sheriff in the country. Together we did this. We held a city council hearing, not outside the walls, but behind the walls, where Steve actually set it up so those individuals who are returning citizens actually had a voice on the city council record. That's the type of leadership that we have in Sheriff Steve Tompkins, and it's also the type of leadership that we have in our next senator, Joe Kennedy. Let's give it up for my man, Sheriff Steve Tompkins.
So, let me say this. There aren't many better public servants in the Commonwealth than Mr. Tito Jackson. Give it up for Tito Jackson! In fact, city, can you sing too, man?
Hell no. All right. I wouldn't be here. Y'all would be opening up for me.
In fact, the city council meeting that he referenced that was held at the sheriff's department was his idea. He was the one who called me and said, We need to bring the city council inside to see people that can't get outside to hear exactly what's going on. Because if you have a misdemeanor charge, you can still vote. And Tito wanted to make sure that people were not going to be overlooked when it came time to vote. So one more time for Mr. Tito Jackson in the house. Now, you know what? When Tito talked about Joe calling him, it reminded me, the same thing happened with us at the Sheriff's Department. We got a call saying that Joe Kennedy wanted, this is right after I think you won, Joseph, that he wanted to come to the Sheriff's Department to tour the department and to talk to us about how we were doing, what it is that we do. And we said the same thing. We said, Joe Kennedy wants to come to the Sheriff's Department unsolicited, because it's not always easy to get legislators to come behind the walls to really confront and face and listen to and talk to people that are serving the underserved, the overlooked. Now check this out. When we were in school, we all heard about the American dream, that ideal that says every citizen should have the opportunity to achieve success and prosperity through hard work and determination. But when you have out of control racism, when you have redlining, when you have nonsense like we're having right now with 45, I can't say his name because I can't say his name, but you know who I'm talking about. The guy who puts kids in cages. The guy who says to people in the suburbs, we are not going to have fair housing, low income housing in the suburbs. The guy who says voting by mail is not a good thing. Listen, not only do we need to win this presidency, but we need to win in a resounding way so that this fool cannot come back at us and challenge us. Listen, you all have heard about investing in stocks and bonds. You've all heard about investing in education, in housing. We also invest in those advocates that are looking out for the people. Your vote is basically saying, I am hiring you to do our work, because this government is set up by the people, for the people, and a lot of people in DC have seemed to have forgotten that, but not Joseph Kennedy. Joseph Kennedy remembers. Joseph Kennedy breathes. Joseph Kennedy is public service. And at any time, if there was ever a time that we need an advocate that understands how to bring home the resources, that would be Joseph Kennedy. So please join me in a Roxbury rounding, surrounding, rousing round of applause for Joseph E. Kennedy!
I don't know what to say after that, Sheriff.
Follow that.
Thanks. Sheriff, let me follow that just by starting out with... Thank you. I'm grateful to call you a friend. I'm grateful for your help and your support. I'm grateful for the example that you set.
Amen.
For somebody that is consistent, always put the people that you serve first. For somebody, I was at a... This was 2 months ago, 6 weeks ago. Sheriff and I were in Nubian Square at a demonstration on the birthday of Breonna Taylor. And as we were standing there, a gentleman started me in a conversation. And he had a medical band on his wrist. And he was talking about the struggles that he had with healthcare and some of the long-term challenges that he had because he had been incarcerated for a long time. And the sheriff was standing next to him. And folks, to watch and to hear the conversation that the sheriff had, knowing that a few months before, that man was behind the wall. And now, homeless and living on that bench, asking for help. And that's what he did, day after day. That's who he is. Sheriff, I'm grateful for the example, for your friendship, and for your dedication to public service, always. And Tito, thank you, my friend. So grateful for Tito Jackson. Grateful for... grateful for your dedication to your community, for being willing to save me from that dance floor at Enrique's wedding. Thank you for that. It was gonna get ugly there real quick, so thank you. For always throwing your constituents a lifeline. And for also recognizing that the work never ends. And the legitimacy that you bring from the service and dedication that you've shown throughout your life, to share that with me in this campaign, I am forever grateful to you, sir. So thank you very, very much. Give it a big up for Tito one more time. And one other person I want to recognize, because this has been a long campaign, and for 5 months we've been locked in our attic, and we haven't been able to get out, and we haven't been able to get about. And so we're trying to make up for lost time now. But she can't come everywhere, but she came here tonight. Because my wife, Lauren, loves Roxbury. Judging by the sound of the applause, you all realize I married up. Thank you. Thanks for coming. Everybody, I am so grateful that you are here. We have been on this campaign trail for the past nearly a year. And for 5+ months, as I said, we've been locked inside. And I cannot tell you how grateful I am to be out of that attic. I cannot tell you how grateful I am to actually see and hear and talk to people. Because politics, more than anything, is still about people. It's about meeting them where they are and having that conversation and asking, how can we help? And what's going on? And what do you need and what can we bring? And I've spent the last 10 months... More pizza is one thing. I've spent the last 10 months running around this Commonwealth, doing that to the best of our ability, given the circumstances. But 10 months ago, down the street, on our announcement weekend, we were in the corner of Mass and Cass. And a woman came up to me and said, look, you don't get it. I have done everything I can to try to battle addiction. And still, in this state, this is where you send me, on a street corner, begging for help. I was in Springfield a couple weeks ago with a young woman and her husband who had a delicious barbecue restaurant. And her and her brother, they cut a hole in the wall to install a takeout window so that she could survive and her business could survive through COVID-19. About 2 months ago, I was at a homeless camp in Arlington off of Route 2 that I didn't know even existed before. And I talked to a man there who was in a tent who had a heart attack 2 days beforehand. 2 days. And 2 days later, he's back in a tent in the woods off Route 2. Because he said, that is where I feel most comfortable. Where our society has let him feel comfortable is in a tent in a woods after a heart attack. Because we've had conversations with family after family that are desperate for access to childcare. We're desperate before this crisis. But they want to get back to work, but they can't get back to work if somebody can't care for their kids. And if they can't get back to work, how are they going to pay their rent or their mortgage or find any way to make ends meet? And family after family, in place after place. We were in Grove Hall a couple weeks ago. Immigrant family had been here for 35 years. Brought his entire family in to try to make that pizzeria work. Because they were struggling to get by. And to a person, knowing how hard these times were, but to a person, optimistic about that future. If they can get folks that will fight for it as hard as they are fighting for their families. If they will have senators that will fight for them as hard as they are fighting for their families. And folks, Massachusetts is my home. It's where I was born, it's where I was raised. This place helped make me. It's where Laura and I are raising our kids. And you cannot go across our city, you cannot go across our state and be anything but inspired by the grit and the determination and the resilience of the people you meet. But they are also asking for a little help. They're asking to be seen and to be heard and have a government that will meet them where they are and will fight for them to say, we see you, we hear you, and we know you can deliver for your family. Let us help you through it. Let's come together and take down those barriers and lift you up. And let's make sure you have that future. Yeah. But if we're gonna do that, it means change. And we got 31 days to prove it. We got 31 days to say we can in fact be that big, bold future we wanna be. But it's gonna take some tough change. And to get there for the next 31 days, so that I can continue that fight, I need your help. I need everything you got. I need you to make those phone calls. I need you, as long as we can, to knock on some of those doors. I need you to reach out to your friends and your family and your cousins and your neighbors. To show more than anything else that if you run a campaign anchored in our communities, listening to the people of Roxbury and Dorchester and Mattapan and Chelsea and Springfield and Lawrence and Lowell, that if you are here and we are fighting for you, then there ain't nothing we can't do together. That is my bet. It is on our Commonwealth. It is on all of you. And I need your help to prove it for the next 31 days.
You got it!
Let's go get it. Let's have some fun. And let's go get this one done. Thanks so much, everybody.
Thank you. I'm a huge, your son has done so much for me. I'm so grateful.